Without further ado, we're going to start off the award ceremony here with the first marathon awards. And I think, I don't recall as many first marathons as this year. So we got a bunch of them. So I think we can do a batch award. I'll call up names and their races and times. Everybody can just kind of come up all at once and we can give a big clap. It's quite an accomplishment. I got misty when I finished my first marathon several years ago. It's just an amazing accomplishment. It's one of those things that you just want to get off, tick off on your list of things to do. First marathon award goes to this bunch of wonderful runners. Gregory Wall, 2009 New York Marathon in 2020. I didn't see Todd here. In 4:27 at the Bay Marathon, Lori Parks ran a 4:34. Michael Parks, a 4:32 at the 2011 Vermont City Marathon. Jessica Hutchins. It's Jessica, go by Nikki. Ran a 4:21 at the Maine Marathon. Elise Bonowitz ran a 4:43 at the Maine Marathon. Christine Racine ran a 5-hour, 45-minute at the Stonecat Marathon Trail Race. That sounds very hard. Amy Heidegger, the 2011 Vermont City Marathon in 4:19. William Obie, Vermont City in 4:39. Scott Schmitz, Vermont City Marathon, 5:33. Wanda Mitchell, Maine Marathon in 5 hours, 5 minutes. Debbie Rodriguez, Maine Marathon in 3:29. Kara Harling Murphy, Mount Desert Iron Marathon in 5:14. Jamie Tardo, Vermont City Marathon in 4:11. And a happy belated first marathon to Jim Haddo, who ran Sugarloaf last year at 3:30.
Did you do
your first?
Yes. And Abby did
hers.
No.
Did you register to be a
plaque?
It's
going to
be afterwards, so
I'll
meet
your
plaque. Oh.
We got to get Abby.
If you ran your first marathon and did not get a plaque this evening, please see me after class. I'm sorry.
Maybe everyone that knows those people can take them so you don't have to mail them?
Yes, I can. Next up, age category winners.
If you know these people, come and take their awards so we don't have to mail them, please.
Outstanding runner, age 19 and under female, Michaela Ashby. Michaela Ashby set the pace at the 7th Pace 5K, ran a 26:21. At Greenlee Tea Day, she ran a 25:53 5K. She's 9 years old. She dominated her age category. Outstanding runner, age 19 and under male, goes to Max Payson. Highlights include a 16:47 breakaway 5K and a 16:32 Father's Day 5K.
He's my son.
Great performance this year.
He's your son.
Outstanding runner, age 20-39, female, Amy Lilly, ran 19:18 at the Goose Rock Beach 5K and another sub-20 performance at the breakaway 5K. Outstanding, these runner, I didn't see those runners. Outstanding runner, age 20-39, male, Phil DeRusso, 36:36 at Portland Trails 10K, and a swift 17:41 performance at the Patriot 5K, among other highlights. Outstanding runner, age 40-49, Stephanie Atkinson. No. Outstanding runner, age 40-49, ooh, this is a male. This is very competitive, and actually it was a very difficult decision because it was such a deep field. This year's award goes to Peter Bottomley. A couple of 1608s I saw in there against some very difficult fields. Congratulations, Peter Bottomley. Outstanding runner, age 50 to 59, Jeannie Hackett, female. Did I see Jeannie Hackett earlier?
No, she said she couldn't come.
Well, that's not great on her mantle of other trophies because she dominates year after year, and I feel bad for almost any female in that age category that has to be, although there are a couple that are getting there. We'll see next year who gets it. Outstanding runner, age 50-59 male. You know, it's everybody's favorite Tom Ryan. A 36:53 at the LLB 10K, and zillions of other races and accolades this year. Just outstanding performance, and he beat me up the hill the other night at the end of our 5-miler in South Portland. It's pretty impressive. Outstanding runner, age 60-69, female. Congratulations, Gretchen Reed. Great running, Gretchen. Outstanding runner, age 60-69. I did see this runner here, Steve Moriarty. And that certainly didn't stop. Unfortunately, runners run on their legs and not on their arms, so slow them down. Highlights include a 21:18 of Moxie Day 5K and a 42:48 at the LLB 10K, among many, many other races that Steve ran this year. Outstanding runner, age 70-79, female. We all know I'm not Paula Kessler. Father's Day 5K and a 47:21 at Clan Festival.
Thank you.
Outstanding runner, age 70-79, male. This is a very deep field, very competitive. Lots of runners running neck and neck, and they run a lot of races, these guys. Dick LaJoy. He ran 24:39 at Carryman's Pub and dozens of other races. Just very impressive running. Outstanding runner, age 80 and over. Ruth. Where's Ruth?
Florida.
I don't think there's any Ruth, her award in person in Florida.
I'll take it to her.
We should send a team down there. Outstanding runner, age 80 and over, male. Mel Uchenik. Am I saying that right?
Yes, Uchenik.
I'm from the Midwest. I'm used to Olson and Johnson. Mel's on here. Congratulations, age category winners. Outstanding winners. Just a heads up, I've got it in the works. We started talking about this a little bit on the race committee last year, but we're going to try to streamline the process for age category awards next year. We're going to try to do a Grand Prix series. Basically, take all the main track club events and a handful of other races in Maine throughout the running season and do a point system. More objectivity is what we're trying to get into it. Right now, we currently take the top 3 or 4 runners in each category who are very close, and it's hard to kind of know which one, you know, is the best, and you got to look, you know, which ones did they compete against each other in. That's not always the case. You know, you can't really examine it at that level. So we're going to try to come up with a little more objective system, point system. I don't know if we can rig it where every main track club member is automatically enrolled in the Grand Prix series, or if it's something that you register for in addition to registering to become a member. But it's I'm excited about it, and hopefully I can get this off the ground this year. If not this year, definitely next year. But that is in the works, so look forward to it. Main Track Club Grand Prix Series. Moving on to the special awards. I really apologize that I didn't get this person her first marathon award. It was certainly well deserved. But she's up for Most Improved Runner of the Year. This runner received several nominations. She's been running for about 5 years, and she completed her first marathon this year, not to mention Mount Washington and other races, including triathlons. She's putting a lot of hard work to accomplish her goals, and she shows up every day and is a mentor to her training, with her friends. I'm talking about Cheryl Brackett. This one was another very difficult decision because there's so many great volunteers in this organization. Wish we could give everyone a big hug who shows up on race day, all the race directors, all the people directing traffic, handing out water. I guess I can say thanks to the board members. That's volunteering, right? But it doesn't seem like it. It's so much fun to be on the board. It doesn't even seem like work or volunteering. It's just fun. This nominee has been a very good runner for many years. Unfortunately, he hasn't been able to run much since early last summer because of a nagging foot injury. In true main track club spirit, he filled his time by volunteering for numerous races, often showing up on crutches while his foot was healing. You show up on crutches, you get the award. Congratulations, Dave Howard. Comeback Runner of the Year. Some pretty good contenders in this group. Dealing with cancer is a tough blow. It's something very difficult to deal with. For a runner, a serious illness can be particularly troubling. This runner has dealt with cancer, has inspired many of us with his attitude and good spirits. And congratulations, Bill Pierce. Outstanding contribution to Maine running. This awardee has changed the lives of many new runners and never complains about giving his time to somebody else. Lots of nominations for this person. Many members recognized this runner for taking numerous beginner and walk runners and helping them on their way to their first 5K, 10K, and even the marathon. Spends countless hours on his time coaching and encouraging each and every one of them. He's their biggest cheerleader. He's a great guy and huge advocate for the sport running, and we recognize Roger Morris. Spirit of the club. Got spirit inside, baby. This runner is recognized for her eagerness to spread the word about Maine Trout Club.